In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. In the waters of baptism, Sylvia died with Christ to rise with him to a new life. May this holy water remind us of our own baptism, when we died with Christ to rise with him to a new life, who lives with him who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
On the day of her baptism, Sylvia was clothed in white. May this white garment remind us of our own Christian dignity, dignity that we received when we were baptized in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Let us pray. Most faithful God, lively is the courage of those who hope in you. Your servant Sylvia suffered greatly but placed her trust in your mercy. Confident that the petition of those who mourn pierces the clouds and finds an answer, we beg you give rest to our sister. Do not remember her sins, but look upon her sufferings and grant her refreshment, light, and peace. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah.
On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples. The web that is woven over all nations, he will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all. Will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather was raised, who is also at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. What will separate us from the love of Christ? Will anguish or distress, or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No, in all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the crowd, "Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. This is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You may be seated for a couple of minutes, maybe a little longer. I understand that you are not from our parish, that you are from St. Ignatius, but we welcome you to our church for the celebration of our liturgical goodbye for Sylvia, our sister in the faith, and your relative and your friend. There cannot be more reassuring words in the church and in the Bible itself, but in the message that we received in the Gospel of today, when Jesus reassures us that we will not be lost because we were given to, from God the Father gave us all and each and all to him so that we might be saved. And this is not only reassuring, but also has like in the blank, like out there in the space, but it has some substance, and the substance is given to us in the letter to the Romans, where we read that, first of all, we are chosen ones by God. It's not like we chose him first, but he actually chose us. When I hear this in scripture, I always think when I go to the market and I choose the fruits that I want, I choose the things that I love. And if something looks like I don't want it, or it has a little bit of an imperfection, I put it aside for someone else to pick. I pick the things that I like. God has chosen us through Christ to be his children. And he has given each and all of us, he has handed us over to Christ so that we may be saved. Because God knows one thing, we cannot save ourselves on our own. We can't do that. That's beyond our nature, beyond our capabilities. But God knows that Christ can save us. And that's why we have been given, each one of us has been given to Christ so that Christ may save us. And it is through the grace, through the active grace that lives, that lies within us, we believe that it is the grace that was given to us in baptism and the grace that is given to us in our Catholic Church through the sacraments, but in Christian life in general, it is given to us through our relationship with Christ. When we relate with him, when we see him constantly in prayer, in the activities that we do, big or large or small, God gives us of his grace. Christ graces us with his presence, and that's how we make it in life. That's how we become acceptable to God's eyes. As we celebrate this Mass for the repose of the soul of our sister Sylvia, we ask God that, we thank God in the first place for having strengthened her during her final days as she struggled with illnesses, as she probably, most probably with pain. We thank God for the grace that he gave her so that she would remain in him. In a similar way, we also ask the Lord to give us of his presence, to give us of his grace, that we may keep strong in the difficulties of life, and that at the end of our lives, we may be ready to receive the final embrace that God gives us, the embrace of mercy, the embrace of peace. May the soul of Sylvia and the souls of our faithfully departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Let us pray for our sister and all our intentions.
Let us pray for Sylvia, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for our sister Sylvia, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life. May she be raised up on the last day. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may one day be gathered again in God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer.
Let us pray that God may welcome into his glory those of our family and friends who have departed this life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord Jesus, hear our prayer. Father in heaven, hear our prayers and intentions through Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be near, O Lord, we pray to your servant Sylvia, for on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault have affected her, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is really right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone, Jesus accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man, Jesus chose to die so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord. And profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Joe, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Sylvia, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and the sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
For those of you who are practicing Catholics and would like to receive Holy Communion, you may form a line or two at the center, please.
If you cannot receive Holy Communion today, please say this prayer with me. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Just
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Sylvia, who has journeyed from this world, may, by the sacrifice of Christ, be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Sylvia in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon her in this life. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates to paradise to your servant, and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are one with you and with our sister Sylvia forever and ever.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her final place of rest.
I know that my Redeemer lives.
Tired.